Hey everyone, it's Nancy, and I just finished doing a video filming the making of this balsa box, and it's going to be at the tail end of this, but I just wanted to go over some of the things that I did. First of all, there is a tutorial on covering the box with the paper. I had several requests on that when I posted my last box, but that is in a separate video. So, for this little box, I used the beautiful peon paper. Absolutely love it. This is from the Forget Me Nots collection. And I used actually some Jenga pieces for the feet, and they are perfect size. They fit absolutely perfectly the width for the boxes, and they give it a little bit of height. And I added this really pretty, really dainty trim around here. I think I got this from Jo when she was my secret squirrel, but I don't really remember. But I think I did get it from Jo. And then these are some pearls. I love this color. It's like a champagne-y color. Really pretty. And these are from Carla's Etsy. And I think I got these from Arlene, but not sure. They may have been from Jo as well. And I used some of that trim for the little hinge part for the box, and I struggled with that, and you'll see in the video me fighting with it. One part in the video, I do know that my memory card was full, and some of it might, I think just adding some of the trims might not be in the video, so I do apologize for that. This under here, this is some of the white Nancy trim from Carla's Etsy, and in the video you'll see me color it up. I used the antique linen distress stain and the gathered twigs because I just wanted to tone it down, and I really love how shabby it looks and really vintage looking. And this is the bloomers trim, and then I put some more of the pearls here. I just put them together on the end and stuck them in there and then back in here. And then these are some of the Juliana ribbon roses, the porcelain ribbon roses from Carla's Etsy. And these are in the blue, and they're so pretty, and they match this blue on this paper perfectly. So I definitely had to use those. And then a gardenia from Watercolor Crafts that I inked the edges with the gathered twigs. Again, that is my new favorite color, and I'm using it on everything. It's like the perfect brown. And in here, these are some new little flowers. They're kind of like baby's breath that Carla got in her store. I'll show you how they come. They come like this, and I just, just cut them apart. And they're really, really cute. They have like little pearl centers. Put some there, and then some more back here under this pearl strand. And so that's the box, and you can see where I added the paper that was on the top is what I put for the feet. And that's it. So I love doing these little boxes. They're really fun, quick and easy. And again, I did record the process of making it, and there is a separate tutorial on how I cover my boxes. So if you have any questions, just let me know. Thanks for watching, and here we go. Thank you.
Thank you.